Hi, my name is Ryan, and I'm an engineer here at Keysight Technologies. Having to manually enter ENR tables for each new noise source can be frustrating. The potential for user error can also become a liability. Today I'd like to demonstrate Keysight's smart noise sources and smart external preamp when used with the new NFA. These devices automate a significant portion of the measurement process. Let's get started. If you look down at the bottom, you'll see that we have an error saying there is insufficient data because the ENR table is empty. Let's go ahead and fill that by navigating to the Measurement Setup menu panel. We will tap the ENR button and then Edit Mej Table. And now I'm going to plug in the noise source. You'll see the user cal is valid, and all of these values were just filled in. These values were pre-populated, so I didn't have to enter them manually, which could have taken several minutes. The noise source we just connected is measuring its internal temperature and sending that information to the NFA in real time. If we go back to the ENR window, we can see that our T-cold is currently set to the default of approximately 296 Kelvin, but we can decide to use the internal temperature. This is updating approximately once a second with the internally measured temperature of the noise source. Let's exit out of this ENR window, and now I'm going to plug in the external USB preamp. You'll see the hardware configuration is updating, cal data is loaded from the USB preamp. The external preamp has sent all of the relevant parameters into the NFA, including some real-time parameters such as gain and temperature, in order to keep your measurement uncertainties down. We just saved ourselves a lot of time by using the automated features of the NFA. Need to increase measurement efficiency? Look no further than Keysight's smart noise sources and external USB preamps. With built-in expertise and a best-in-class preamp, our NFA helps you minimize your uncertainties. If you would like more information, please visit the URL shown on the screen. Thanks for watching!